If you spend your life trying to get all the stress and tension out of your life, your life's not going to go very far. You're not going to grow much. Now, there's a really important piece to this. Really successful people believe that stress grows them, and through cycles of stress and relaxation, they grow. So in this video, I want to talk about tension. And you guys know I love talking about tension. But in this case, I want to talk specifically about turning tension into flow, or turning tension into flow states. You see, tension is the activator of flow states. And flow states are where everything gets done. It's where magic happens. It seems like where the impossible happens, where you can do basically anything. So how do we get this feeling of flow? How do we get this feeling of a flow state? Well, actually, before I cover that, I'm going to give you an example with flirting. I've been out, I remember the first time it happened, really happened, I was out in a bar and I started flirting and I just flirted a little more. And for some reason, I didn't know why that night, suddenly it seemed like I could do no wrong. Every girl I talked to was suddenly responding. Girls were getting nervous. I was starting to step into the tension more, but the more I stepped into the tension, the more they would enjoy me. I could start to see the matrix. I could tell when a girl liked me even before I walked up. I could tell when a girl was checking me out. I remember I was standing at the bar one time. I was leaning against the bar talking to my buddy. He was to my right, and we were sitting there having a nice conversation. And I suddenly saw this girl on the other side of him. I was kind of glancing, and I went like this, and I looked around him to look at her, and she suddenly went and looked, leaned back, and I could tell she got nervous. I knew right in that moment, because I was in this flow and I'd been flirting and everything was just working, and I was kind of talking to him about this flow state that I was in, that she liked me. And I said, hold on 1 minute. And I pushed my friend out of the way. I reached over, grabbed her hand, and just pulled her over. And I remember this is one of the early times when I first started to experience flow in bars. And she giggled and she laughed. And then she immediately looks at me, looks big doughy eyes, and goes, "I'm shy." And I just immediately laughed. I calmed her down. We started talking and we started going from there. There was a bunch more things that happened that night that were absolutely amazing. And it really blew my mind, this whole idea of flow state. And I'd heard about it. I had experienced a little bit jogging, but I'd never fully experienced it in communication before. And this was really powerful. You see, tension is the activator of these flow states. I'm sure you've had flow states in your life. It could be in a sport. It could be, I'm a snowboarder, so I've had flow states in snowboarding. It could be as a skier. It could be as a mountain climber. It could be in public speaking. I get flow states in public speaking, where it's just like everything gets fed to you. And I want to talk about how that happens and how to turn that on. Because I believe that as we become more conscious, more awake, more alive in life, we are designed to live more and more in flow states. But if you're afraid of tension, you don't step into tension, you don't play with tension, you can't turn on flow states. Because flow states need the right balance. It's about a balance between tension and feeling. This idea of feeling as emotions and the flow of emotions. So if we got a hose, the hose goes from the spigot and goes all the way out to the garden and feeds the garden water. And what happens is that hose has to receive water from the spigot and let it flow through the hose to the water. Now, no tension at all means no hose, because the tension is the guiding force. It doesn't force the water, it guides the water and allows the water to flow through. So think about that for a sec. It allows the water to flow, it doesn't force the water. If you take the hose and you kink it off, that's too much tension. That's the over application of tension. If you kink it in a bunch of spots, the hose would become, in a sense, dead or numb. You ever feel numb anywhere in your body? Think about that as too much tension in that area where you're tightening up and cutting off feeling. And that's actually a feeling in and of itself. And to me, this numbness, this apathetic state that people get into, is, in a sense, an emotion itself. It's the overload of emotion. So now think about flow. If we got flow and there's not enough tension and we take away the hose altogether, what are we left with? We're left with the water just dissipating. It can't travel from point A to point B. So if you want to grow your garden and you want all these beautiful vegetables, you need to move the water from point A to point B, and you need that guiding force. Well, that's what the masculine is. The masculine is the guiding force for power, for that flow. And to get into it, to enter into it, you have to step into tension. A life without tension is a dead life. Without tension on your body, you would atrophy and die. Think about bodybuilding for a minute. How do you build big muscles or become an elite athlete? It's through the application of stepping into tension. There's going to be days when you don't want to do it, when you have to force yourself, when you're not surrendering, when you're pushing. And then there's other days when you reach that point of surrender and you grow to the next level. And that's beautiful and that's powerful. But if you run from tension your whole life, what are you more likely to be like? A big sloppy couch potato, huge fat, out of shape, because you're avoiding all the stuff that you would need to do to grow yourself. Same thing with bodybuilding. If you don't lift weights, how do you build muscle? You know, if you don't do some form of exercise where you step into tension. But there's also got to be a balance to it. There's the stepping into tension and then the relaxation and the letting go. So now we're back into flow through the relaxation. So I step into tension and then I relax. And in time, we start learning to calibrate these two and we get better and better. We begin to enjoy both. And as we begin to enjoy both, these sweet spots hit where the feeling and the tension are so imbalanced that we're in a flow state now. So there's books written on this, The Zone, and I think it was The Rise of Superman. I think it's Kotler. And these books talk about these flow states and how people are breaking world records by hitting these flow states. And these flow states, to me, are akin to enlightenment or high levels of consciousness. They're these brief satoris where we experience this high level of consciousness, unity with our body, and therefore unity with everything out around us. Because that's what's really happening in these states. You see, you have a frontal lobe in the brain, which holds the focus of what you want to do. It's like, I'm going to go that way. I'm building this business. I'm building that business. I'm going to make this happen. I'm going to talk to that girl. And when you activate that frontal lobe, if you push too hard, let's say you're one of those super analytical guys like I used to be, and you're going to push, what's going to happen is you're going to bind up right here and you're not going to communicate with the rest of your body. It's going to be all head and you're going to force it. And the girl's going to perceive you as heady. She's going to perceive you as pushing too much. You're going to eventually burn out your willpower. You only have so much willpower. And when that willpower burns out, what's left? Nothing. You just get tired and you just want to fall asleep. So think about that for a minute, or you just want to quit. That's more like you want to quit. I said fall asleep, but that could happen. But it's more like you just want to quit. You just want to stop. You're just like, I'm done. I'm tired. I don't even want to think about this. And maybe you burn out so much from pushing so hard over days and weeks that you don't even look at it for months again. That's pushing too much. In reality, really successful people are great at setting something up in their frontal lobe and then just relaxing and knowing, believing, having a sense of expectancy. This is where the term faith comes in, that it's going to happen. What happens from there? Because their mind doesn't wander, they keep moving back to it. They keep moving, like every time their mind wanders, you go, nope, this has happened. It's almost like this has happened. It's not even going to happen. This has happened. It's happened in my imagination, so it's going to happen in the physical world. The physical world's just got to catch up with my imagination, because it all happens here first in my imagination, and then eventually the physical world catches up. That's the application of tension. Every time your body wants to pull you back away and say, now you can't do this. Nope, it is going to happen. No, you can't do this. No, it is going to happen. This is going to happen. And in that, you're resolving stories. This is what tension does. It's the resistance that pushes through things and makes you stronger and stronger and stronger till you can walk through all that resistance with ease. And it starts to show up in your life. Now, there's a little bit more to this, and you need to understand the other part and why it's so important. You need to relax into it and not force it. You see, you only have so much energy powering your body. And when you force yourself to focus on something over and over and over and over and over again, trying to make it happen, what happens again, like I said earlier, is that energy binds up here and it never runs through the rest of your body. Your body is a machine. It's a powerful machine that helps to create your reality. It's like the vehicle you take on the freeway. Like if you were going to go on the Autobahn, you want to take a really nice car, a really good, well-tuned sports car to handle those speeds, right? If you're going to race in a race. Well, when you go through life, I want to have the best feeling body possible, because that's how we navigate life. We navigate feeling the tension and the emotion and the vulnerability of other people. That's how we navigate. It's like waves of energy and we bounce off of it. And as you get more in tune with this, it becomes more and more obvious what people are feeling, what they're thinking. Women do this more naturally. They feel the feelings more naturally. Men feel the tension more naturally. We feel the push and we're going to make stuff happen. But if you think about this for a minute, if you get good at just holding an idea and expecting it to happen, and you start to learn to relax into it, whether through meditation or the revealing process, which we teach here, which is getting all the stories that you can't do it out of your nervous system, which is really a power system when you get it turned on, then what happens is that energy starts to drop down and you start to feel more. There's a sense of dropping down in your body. And pretty soon you start to feel it. You feel it drop all the way down the front of your body like a waterfall. You begin to feel your heart, and your heart opens, which is more expression. And then you drop into your stomach where your gut brain is. And if you look up gut as a second brain, it's a very real scientific thing. When the heart falls in love with what you're focused on, and then the gut gets a hold of it, because now I'm choosing this, I'm in love with this, this is beautiful, this is gonna happen, I'm enjoying it. Then the gut gets a hold of it, because you're not resisting in the gut anymore. Then what happens is your gut turns on, your gut instincts kick in, and that's what the gut does. If you look up gut as a second brain, you'll see that the gut actually is what controls flow state. See, the gut sends these guttural instincts. It says, go here, turn left here. It's how you stay on the surfboard when you're on the surfboard or the snowboard. You make all those insane amount of micro adjustments to your body not to fall over. It's because your gut is adjusting and feeling the moment much faster than this brain can. This brain's got the idea, it's holding it, but the gut brain is telling the body how to move. And when you surrender to the body, that's when it goes into flow state, this beautiful flow state. And if you're fighting and pushing and pushing and fighting, you're cutting off the feeling. Remember, there's the masculine and the feminine. The masculine creates a nice container so that that feeling can flow into the body, and then the body can respond to it. If you cut it off by over-pushing, overthinking, trying to force, jam affirmations down your head, that resistance is gonna burn out your willpower eventually. And that's why we have to stop that. So, and then eventually it drops all the way down into your turn-on, you know, down in your hips, and you ground it with your legs into the earth, and you begin to move forward. This all starts with the application of tension. You got to be able to apply tension to be able to relax into the body. Now, an example of this is simple. You've seen people like this, I used to be one. If I focus here and I start cutting off my body and I'm gonna make it happen, and I walk up to say hi to you, and now I'm walking out of my body. Hey, how you doing? My name's Brian. What's yours? Well, where are you from? Do you feel a sense that my energy's going up now? And I'm even still in a little bit of feeling, but if I really locked out and I was really nervous, I'd be like, hey, what's your name? Where are you from? Hi, yeah. Do you feel that? That's a sense that energy goes up. That's because I'm tight through the whole body. This is the whole intent of yoga. So then if I do this, let's say I relax a little into the chest, but I lock out at the intercostals, the rib cage, and I tighten up there, then I'm gonna be like, a little better. I'm gonna be, hey, how you doing? My name's Brian, what's yours? And that's still a little grounded. I'm actually a little bit right in here. So if I can come up a little higher, lock out a little more. Hey, how you doing? My name's Brian. There's that sense of a little bubble up here. And then I drop down into my intercostals and I relax in here. And I relax lower in my body and even lower, and I start to drop down. Then I can be like, hey, hey, how you doing? My name's Brian, what's your name? Oh, where are you from? Tell me more about that. And you start to relax more. So there's a big drastic difference between me walking up to somebody and I have the intention to say hi, a beautiful woman, and I walk up and I say, hi, my name's Brian, what's your name? Where are you from? That's me vacating my body. And I'm gonna go all the way down now so you see the drastic difference. And me walking up and just looking down at the person, saying, hey, how you doing? My name's Brian, what's your name? And there's a big difference between those two. And I know it doesn't seem like a lot to really analytical guys, but to a woman who can feel all my emotions, it's huge. And 1 minute of talking from feeling and enjoying somebody, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes is huge. And if you don't have the application of tension, if you're not comfortable with the tension, you can't do that. On top of that, you have to step into tension just to walk over. Like, let's say I'm over here, I'm a natural feeling guy, I'm relaxed, I'm calm. And then as I walk over, because I have issues with women, I start going up. Hi, how you doing? Versus the guy that walks over and he enjoys the tension. Like he gets a rush from the tension. And he drops down and he walks over and he's more relaxed. And he's like, hey, how you doing? My name's Brian. That difference is still huge because now she's got a human being to talk to. Locked out of my head, nervous, and right now my emotions are light. So even locked in my head, I feel light. But if I was heavy, like I was depressed or I was sad or I was like locked out or I was, and I did that, oh my God, it'd be horrible. And so this is why tension is so important. And this is also why tension activates flow states, because the more you do it and get comfortable feeling your own body, which is what we talk about. We talk about embodiment, energetic embodiment to be specific, not exercise embodiment. Then what happens is you start to convey all these beautiful emotions through feeling and through flow. These turn on, joy, happiness, because you become a channel for those emotions through the application of tension. But what that's going to start with is you probably creating too much tension at first, and then too little tension, and then too much. It's the same as getting on a bike like the first time. First you're overcorrecting, then you're undercorrecting, then you're overcorrecting, then you get too rigid and you fall over because you're too much. And then eventually you relax into it, and then there's a sense of flow. And that's what we're looking for with everything. I don't care if it's sports, I don't care if it's public speaking, I don't care if it's your new job. You're looking for that flow state. And ultimately, as we become more conscious, we live more and more in that flow state. If you spend your life trying to get all the stress and tension out of your life's not going to go very far. You're not going to grow much. Now, there's a really important piece to this. Really successful people believe that stress grows them, and through cycles of stress and relaxation, they grow. There's a great TED Talk on this by Kelly McGonigal, How to Make Stress Your Friend. It's a 17-minute TED Talk that illustrates this point beautifully, that people that think that stress is bad for them and are constantly trying to get out of their lives have very small lives and tend to have the most problems, failures, illnesses, and so forth. People that think stress is good for them and use stress to grow in healthy cycles, like, you know, I get my rest, I get my massage, and I get back out there and hustle again, and I work out again, and I push myself again, tend to have the best lives. They have the most growth, the best success, and so forth. I highly recommend you check out that video, How to Make Stress Your Friend. They did a study, I believe it was 30,000 people over 8 years, but don't quote me on that. But the most successful group and the happiest group and the healthiest group was the group that thought stress was good for them, and they had a high level of stress in their life. They were killing it. And I am constantly working at getting more comfortable with tension and stress. How do you turn a seed into a tree? You bury it in the ground, and it has to dig down through the dirt and has to fight its way to the surface and through the seasons to become ultimately a giant tree. How do you do anything? You need a certain level of tension. If I want to build the Empire State Building, there has to be a hell of a lot of tension holding that thing together. And so tension is magical. And tension, with its perfect guiding force, doesn't feel like tension. When the tension is in balance with the water, it feels like flow. Because now there's that perfect glide, like the riverbed over the river, you know, things like that. But it starts with a little bit pushing into it to find that, because you got to find the balance. You got to play and be out of balance till the balance shows up. And that's the beauty of flow states. And this is especially true for all you look at learning to approach women. This is the art of learning to be good with approaching women, talking to women, flirting with women, being good on dates, is playing in that flow, playing in that tension. If you're constantly getting rid of tension with women, and you're constantly getting rid of tension on your approaches, and you're not grounding tension, well, you just don't seem confident. Matter of fact, I didn't say this earlier in the video, the man that appears the most confident to women is the man that can relax into the most tension. He can step into tension, and he can relax and have a good time. That is a confident man. Everybody's got that in some area of their life. Maybe you've got it in your job. Maybe you've got it in public speaking. Maybe you've got it in music. Maybe you've got it with women. I knew one guy that had it with women, but he was horrible with any type of dangerous sports. He was scared to death. I knew another guy that had it with sports and really dangerous stuff, but he was horrible with women. He would freak out and go to his head. So everybody's got it somewhere, or they've got it better in some place. Look at that place and notice how different you feel in that place. It's huge. And this is why we encourage you to begin to master your tension skills and constantly look for the flow inside of them. This is why we encourage the tension journal. You know, get a journal. And we're actually going to create these someday. If you guys want us to create a tension journal, put it in this video. But someday we're going to create a tension journal. It's this whole simple idea that you write down in your journal at least 5 things every day that has tension in it for you, that makes you nervous. On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 is too much tension, and 1 is very little tension. And if you just practice even the 1, 2s, and 3s on a daily basis, stepping into 1, 2s, and 3s and journaling about it, what you learned from them, how you grew, you're going to grow radically in 3 months. Your whole life is going to change. I can't tell you how many clients have told me their whole life has changed in 3 months just from doing this. I'd get emails and messages and all kinds of stuff from doing this. So do this every day, at least 5 things a day, 1, 2s, and 3s. And if you want to do an occasional 5, 6, or 7, great. But those 1, 2s, and 3s over time are where the money's at. So it doesn't even have to be a hard application. Eventually, what is an 8 now will move down the scale and be a 5, and then a 4, and then a 3, and then a 2. And you will get better and better and better with tension. And that's the beautiful thing about this. I'm going to give you one more practice. You can take that same idea And you can go out for a half hour or an hour one day and find as many tension opportunities as you can for that hour and just journal each one. Walk down the street in a busy area with lots of people, and maybe you see somebody over there that makes you a little nervous. Walk up and say hi, or wave to them, say hi in passing, and then write down the tension number, what you learned from it. You see somebody throw trash on the ground, everybody looks. You walk over, pick it up, throw it away in front of them because it makes you nervous. You're embarrassed now. Write that, I mean, it's only a two. You write that down. Somebody comes up to ask you for money and you always feel guilty not giving them money, and you look them in the eyes and relax as much as you can because it makes you nervous, and you say, no, not today. And then you let it go and you write down how that makes you feel. And you constantly do this. Watch the rush that will build in your body after about a half hour if you stay in a healthy range. One, two, three, fours. If you try to go really high, you're gonna burn yourself out. But if you, you know, that's that whole pushing. But if you stay in a nice healthy range and you do it over and over and over and over and over again, watch the magic that happens. It actually starts to move you towards flow state. And then when you get good at it, you can start to do this in a bar. Go into a bar and do it. Go into a social setting and do it. Have fun with it. So that's all I really wanted to say on this video. And what I would really love for you guys to do is comment on this video. If you want us to make those tension journals, let us know, because I've been talking about it for a while. I've been thinking about it and I need the motivation. So if that's something you want, I'll put in different sections and make it to where it's just this constantly moving you into a courage, acceptance, love, peace through the application of tension. That's because that's the magic. And we'll give you refills. We'll set up a refill program and all that kind of stuff. So that would be something that would be amazing. Also, just comment about your experience. Go out, do this, put a comment on before, and then go out and do this exercise for like a half hour, and then put a comment in the video again. Let us know what your experience is. I love hearing about these experiences. And then also make sure to like the video if you got any value out of it. I'm hoping you got value. And make sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification if you haven't already. And make sure to share. Your sharing the video really helps us to grow the channel, build and get more viewers, which helps us to create more videos. I love creating this video for you. It's really powerful. We're gonna be creating a lot more. I wanna do a whole series possibly on tension. I'm super excited to do that. So be looking for that as the weeks go on. And also, what would you do if you were not afraid? Think about that when you go out to do your tension journal. That's our other one. What would you do if you were not afraid? Or another way to put it is, what would you do if you were fearless? And with that said, remember, only the confident really live. Have a beautiful day, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.